Hello, and welcome to Tech Talk, where the banker sits down with some of the best and brightest fintech companies in the industry. Today, I'm speaking to Des, CEO and co-founder of Triple Blind. Hello, Des, how are you?
Hello, thanks for having me. I'm really good. I'm in Basel at a conference and having a great time.
Wonderful. I can see we can all tell we're coming out of COVID that your people are traveling again. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we can be a bit more mobile in the world. So excellent. So I'm going to start off with my first question that I ask all fintech companies, which is, what is Triple Blind and what problem are you solving?
Triple Blind is a data sharing company. The way historically we've transacted around data, it is fundamentally broken. We've seen huge breaches and those have caused reputational issues. They've caused consumers to lose trust in banks and fintechs. And at the root of that problem, as we see it, is data transmission. Meaning the way we transact around data is I give you a copy of my data. And so now it's a valuable asset, but it's also a toxic asset. It is something that you need to keep safe and ensure is not abused. And it ultimately comes down to reliance on human trust, which also slows down the pace of innovation. So what Triple Blind is doing is allowing data to be used without ever moving it, replicating it, or copying it in your systems, or allowing for it to be potentially abused. The way we do it is by one-way encrypting to the data so that it may be used only for the purposes explicitly authorized for and not ever abused in a way that would violate consumer trust or would violate a piece of regulation or the business contract that is governing the relationship. So we hope that this way consumers can regain trust in the financial institutions they choose to do business with, as well as the pace of innovation in fintechs and financial services and banks increases rapidly because you're able to implicitly work with untrusted parties. You don't have to rely on individuals to try to keep your data safe. You can get a mathematical guarantee that your data is never able to be abused.
So I'm wondering whether you can go into maybe a bit more detail, because I was looking at what are some of the common challenges that organizations find when they try to share data and collaborate on a global scale.
I'll walk you through maybe three highlights of how the pain point manifests itself. So we've all seen the Capital One breach, where the credit bureaus had your most private data about yourself, right? They knew how much they had, the records of your loans and bank accounts and other debts. And that was shared with Capital One, which kept a copy of it every time you wanted to get a bank account or a credit card or other financial product from Capital One, right? And in that context, what ended up happening was when Capital One suffered a breach, not only was Capital One's data compromised, the credit bureau's data was also compromised, right? So this was an instance where the credit bureaus followed the best practices of the day. However, a breach at a counterparty led to a breach of their data without them doing anything about it, right? And similarly, on the other vein, we also see lots and lots of promising fintechs with all kinds of innovative products that need to get access to data, either from a bank or a financial institution or a credit bureau. And that process is painful and slow, right? Because it requires an ISO 27001 or SOC2 and other cybersecurity products to just get access to the data to do your business. And worst of all, it takes 6 months to a year just to be able to let in, right? And so in those cases, what Triple Blind is enabling is the ability to onboard a new partner without risking your assets. How do I, as a credit bureau, work with a bank and get the guarantees that if the bank is subject to a breach, like some of the banks were, that I am not infringing my customers' or my consumers' data records, which then become public property, right? In a similar vein, how do I, as a bank, work with an innovative fintech that is providing a really great solution potentially for customers without asking them to go through all these compliance and contractual steps that take years and slow it down and also are intrinsically risky? And how do I speed up the pace of innovation there? And at the same time, from the fintech side, how do I not end up with a toxic asset? How do I use the data for the value without ending up with the liabilities and risks of needing to keep it safe? And similarly, we're seeing use cases also in alternative data. We all know that that a lot of these aggregators and phone companies make data available for macro trends. But we've also seen that anonymization processes really are insufficient because we've seen how high value individuals can be re-identified. That just causes an embarrassing issue, right? When, for example, a really prominent individual is re-identified from a quote unquote anonymized data set, right? So what triple blind enables therefore there is the ability to use alternative data without any possibility of a high value individual being able to be re-identified from the data set.
Really fascinating stuff. But I wanted to turn back our final question to more of a personal question. So I'm putting all our fintech founders on a desert island with one book. What book do you choose?
Ooh, that's a good one. So my favorite book of all time is 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. It is a saga of innovation and dreaming about the world. And the beauty of it is, while it was science fiction in its day, it is now all reality. And it's beautiful to see how Jules Verne imagined the future that did eventually come true. And hopefully we're able to reimagine the future that does eventually come true here as well.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Daz. Thank you for speaking with me.
Thank you, Liz. Thanks for having me.